Hello YouTube, welcome to channel 48. My name is Puck, as you already know. Well, I got a tablet for 15 euros today. What can we still do with this thing? It's a Samsung. It's a Samsung Tab 3T210. And I have it here with me. And I want to upgrade it. Well, I want to give it the iOS ROM. So I modded the iOS ROM for it. I never tested the ROM, so we'll have to see if it's gonna work. It's gonna be one big surprise. Also, we will need Twerp. So I'm gonna flash Twerp. I found the Twerp file special for this device. And we're gonna flash that with a Windows computer where we have Audin installed and of course the Samsung USB drivers. So let's see what we can still do with this thing and if the ROM will work. Show you the tablet. This is it. Can you see anything? I'm not sure. Let me put the screen a little bit higher, like this. Okay, so this is it. This is how it looks. And I disabled all the applications that I normally don't use and don't want to see in the stock ROM. Here we have the settings, lovely settings. I think this thing would make a nice little 7-inch iPad, iPad mini. So let's create an iPad mini from this thing. So what to do? Okay, let me first close these pages. Up here, you're gonna see that I have some files. Okay, and I will also, let me see, I also have the Twerp file, Twerp. And that's an MD5 file. So I'm gonna put it into the folder. This folder here. Damn, where's the thing? Oh, my downloads. This one here. So I'm gonna put it into this folder. Okay. I already have Audin installed, and what we now gonna do is put the device into a download mode. Okay, so we just gonna hit reboot, opnieuw, upstart, that's gonna say, and I'm gonna hold down the home and the volume down. That should bring us, there we go, you see that? And with the volume up, we are in an actual download mode. Oh, look at that big Android there. So, let me find my Audin real fast. 3.10. Okay. So it's saying device is added. That's all that is important to me. That driver error, I don't really care about it. So I'm going to put the tablet there so you can see the process. So we're going to hit AP. In the developers options, I could not find anything that said unlock bootloader. Okay, so I think we're good to go. There is the Twerp, and we're gonna hit start. You see that? Boom. I hit volume up and home. I'm too late, so we're just gonna reboot again. Reboot. Yes, we hold volume up and the home. That should bring us into Twerp. We let go when we see the logo. This should bring us into Twerp. There you go, Twerp. You see that? So swipe to allow modifications. I'm gonna do a dirty install because I did not I did not put in a little card. Oh, you see that? So I'm just gonna do a wipe factory data reset. Yeah, effect, I want to advanced. Dalvik system cache data. Okay, we flash them all. So we just flash the complete tablet. And here is the ROM, and we're gonna install it. I hope it's gonna work. And we go into the Aroma installer. Okay, so the ROM was powered by Jasper. It's a Jasper ROM. And we hit next. We go one back. No. Sorry for that. Options, remove PH surface, read my PH surface before selecting this, stock boot animation, no, nothing. This wizard is ready to begin, okay. So there we go, we're installing. And we're installing Nullcat for T210R. This was the lightest ROM that I could find. And I flashed in my applications and of course the boot animation that goes along with it. This will get an iPhone X or a Tab X look and feels if everything goes right. I never flashed this before. And SuperSU installer, so we're gonna have root. Can use our firewall, 99%, 90, 100. Reboot device now. I think this is what we wanted. And now we're gonna reboot. Gonna put the tablet to stand. It has enough battery life already. So there we go. Samsung Galaxy Tab 3. And in fact, I was looking for the 3110. Oh, there it goes. It's booting. Oh, beautiful. Animation looks very good. You see that? It looks amazingly nice. Also, the size is good. Everything is good. It's perfect. Beautiful. Beautiful. So let's see what we're gonna get. I'm gonna let this boot. We're looking at the real-time boot, peeps. So you could see that the upgrade was, it's an upgrade if you're gonna install another firmware on the tablet. And in fact, it's not necessarily immediately an upgrade. Because upgrade would then mean a way higher build of the build that you're on, a higher build. But the upgrade can also be an upgrade in look and feels, an upgrade in the way you're gonna use it, applications, ROM. There we are, almost there, peeps. It just went a little bit darker there. You see, I also cut out some display protection because, in fact, it was all very, very low. So there we go. Next, Wi-Fi is at least working. Can you see anything? It's kind of dark, eh? I'm not sure why it's so dark. Maybe we should turn this off here. There we go. This is better. And we're just gonna skip for now. We have Google services installed, which I will not use. And there we go. Look at that. Wow, amazing. Beautiful. Okay, YouTube has stopped. All right. Lovely. Lovely, lovely, lovely. This thing has no phone, of course. This is a tablet. So I think the coolest apps to put here are the ones that we're gonna use most often, and that is my scanner radio And oh, we have open camera. I want open camera. Yeah. You see that? And this one I don't use so often, but I use this one even more. Okay. This one is not really my thing, but I like to see. I'm gonna add a phone to this thing, because this thing did not come with a phone, so I'm gonna add a VoIP phone. Look at so little apps, beautiful. This is so great. Let me see what we're gonna put there. Maybe the App Store, like this. So this looks nice. Okay, so let's see if iNoti works. Turn on iNoti. Yes, okay. Go one back. And there it is, it's enabled. See that? Oh, c'est très belle. Okay. We go one back. Later. Later, alligator. And let me see. Hey, what is happening here? No, 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 close. Let me close all these, because I'm leaning on my mouse, so this is better. Okay, so our firewall is working. We have a firewall. Let me see if I'm gonna get a pop-up. Super Sue, yes, grant for always. Look at that, enable firewall. This thing just became a great device only because of this. It's amazing. So I will be able to block each and everything that I'm not using, including the firewall. You see the cameras represented in here? Now we don't see the camera anymore in our rooms of these days. We cannot block that anymore. And I really don't know why that is. What happened to that part? Is it now forbidden to block our camera? That's what I'm asking myself. Why was that removed? Because the camera is connected to some port, 10049. But in the later ROMs, Lineage OS and all these ROMs, I don't see it anymore. It's gone. So did they remove the connection to a port, to the internet port of that camera, or is it hidden so we cannot block it anymore? So that's what I'm asking myself. I have many questions that I'm asking myself when it comes up to Android, because I see changes, because I'm always busy with installing and doing lots of crazy things with tablets and devices. So I see these changes. I see when something is happening, it's changing. And then I don't see no clear answer anywhere. And because nobody is using a firewall, you know, nobody really cares. And nobody even knows. Okay, we cannot choose no wallpaper, so the iOS app, yeah, for the installing, it's just fine. But in fact, you should not count too much on it. The wallpapers in the app you will not be able to use, because there is a problem with that. And that is in most of the ROMs that I flashed this iOS launcher into. They all give an error whenever you click the launcher. But some ROMs have no problem with that. And in some ROMs you can easily open them. So the Super Sue and the iNoti I'm gonna hide. I don't wanna see that. This one here, come here and go there. Hey, go there. Eh? Go there. I don't want to go inside. What is this? Beeps, I don't want to go inside. Look at that. Wow, beautiful. Let's see if we can get a nice wallpaper. Oh, this is very old wallpaper. And how about here? What do we have here? Oh, I love this one. I love this one. And this one I also liked. And the wing. But I like mint the best. Oh, look at that. Look at that dock. It's also so very nice, visible. So yeah, this is it, my friends. This is what you can do with a 15 euro tablet. Only I cannot make folders. I think that has to do with... Okay, so you cannot put things in a folder with this ROM. I think it has to do with the build of Android. But hey, I'm happy, man. Look at that. We have everything on board. So only thing that we need now is the internet. So let's connect to the internet. My settings. Let's look at this. Oh, the settings look nice. Nice settings. Very nice settings. Let's turn on the Wi-Fi. Let me connect to the Wi-Fi. Look at this nice, lovely keyboard. You see that? Lovely, man. Really. So probably I will have to update the browser. Oh, wait. You know what? I don't want the App Store here. I want the App Store there. And I want the browser. I hope it's a good browser. I'm not sure. Otherwise, I'm going to update it with another one. So this will not be the final pack for this tablet. This thing, it installed so nice that I'm really surprised to see it running so beautiful. Let's see what's gonna happen here. Oh, it's just an empty tab. No. Exactly how a keyboard should sound. Not these, you know, these things, these buzzes. I hate them. I cannot stand when I touch the screen and it buzzes. I find it very stupid. I make mistake because of that. So everything works, guys. Let's see if YouTube works. Long press will let you close apps, and that is something that I advise you to do. Okay, let's see if my YouTube mod works. Let me see something in the settings. Applications. Oh, let me see what we have from Google here. Google Play Services is installed. Okay, so it just don't like the mod. All right, so I'm gonna show you how powerful we are in this system. Only thing we're gonna do is I'm gonna remove that mod. Because this thing has Play Store, it has Google services installed. So in fact, what I could do is go with my APK Pure, and I can get the official YouTube, and it will work anyhow because we have the services installed. YouTube. There we go. And we can install it without any problem. I install it via my own app store. So I don't have to create the account first and all these things. Because in fact I want to disable this. Unknown sources, we must enable that. Next install. No. App not installed. Wat verdomme. Dat komt natuurlijk. That is because. Wait. Let's do something else. Where is my root browser? There. No. And I'm gonna delete this one. Yes. Root access. Grant forever. Boom. Okay, so that one is deleted. So we can go back to root browser. We go up here to home. You won't have to do that. I'm gonna fix that. So don't worry about what you see now. I'm just doing because I'm doing it for myself. And now we should be able to install YouTube official. Settings. Hey, unknown sources. Tablet is treating unknown sources as if. This should work. No. A decline. Okay, the app is installed. You see that? Boom. Opening. No update. Oh, then it doesn't run. Okay, then I don't want you. Go away. Goodbye. What I should have done is not delete my old YouTube. But I should have shut down the Google Play service because in fact I don't need it. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna go to security and then device administrators. I'm gonna be my own device administrator. Oh no, it's already turned off. Oh, that's beautiful. It's beautiful. So I'm gonna go to applications. And we're gonna go to all. And play service. Clear catch manage. No. Clear all data, yes. And then disable, yes, and a force stop, yes, and never show notification ever again. And then I also want, I saw Google Play Store, where is it? Oh, then it's automatically disabled Play Store. Oh no, there it is. Disable. Clear cache, clear data, yes. Force stop, yes. Don't show notifications ever. Okay. Yeah, the framework I cannot disable. Calendar sync, Google backup transport. Yeah. I think this is all good now. I'm fine. So what I'm gonna do is flash my mod back, including my YouTube mod, and then it's gonna work. It didn't work because Surfaces was installed. That app is meant for when you have no Google Surfaces installed, you see. So let's see how it deals with live TV. Where is my, oh yeah, there it is, here. My fantastic NPO application that I will never let go of. Even though it's gonna say, this version cannot run Chromecast, don't go for the higher build. So this is what you want, nothing more, nothing less. So Politieke Partijen. Live, that's there. Okay. So let's look at. Wow. So live TV works. Beautiful. So yeah, guys, this is my updated iOS ROM. It's the only one worldwide, because at that time nobody was creating iOS ROMs. You know, 4 years ago people didn't do things like that. You know, if you would do a thing like that, it was a sin in Android world to even think of iOS. So this is it, and I hope you like it. I don't like it. I love it. Wow. Such a beautiful thing. So, yeah, I'm going to share this ROM, of course. About the device. Kernel by... Okay, anyway, this was a Jazz BR Light ROM by Great Knoll. Yeah, GR8NOLE. Great Knoll. So, all credits for whatever you saw that I did and that worked, you know, and that installed so fine, was by nobody else, is for nobody else than Great Knoll, okay? Even though he created this years ago, as you can see, in 2018, I still make a great, beautiful device, you know, that has great look and feels from his work. You see that? So, he abandoned this ROM long time ago. He's not working on it anymore. But hey, thanks to him, we can still do this and have a beautiful ROM for this device. The first iOS ROM ever worldwide for the Samsung Tab 3. And here it is in front of you, booting up and looking all great and lovely. So yeah, thumbs up to Great Knoll. Well done. You're a great guy, and whoever else worked on this, thank you very much. It's very nice, very stable, very lovely. And I thought you would never ask me, is the cam working? Video. Yep, it works. We're recording. So you can make videos, pictures. You have a selfie cam as well. So yeah, that all is in this device, and it's all working, peeps. Amazing. That's it. I don't have to make this video any longer, right? I showed you the complete process. Only thing that you need is the twerp and of course the ROM. I will zip them together, put them on my Google page. I'm gonna also give you a link to Great Knoll's ROM, the one without my modding, and go ahead and check it out. He's a great guy. Maybe he will, I don't know, don't even think of it. We will not get Lineage OS for this device. Maybe Lineage OS 11. Maybe somebody can take a look again into this device, because yeah, if you still have this device and you flash this ROM, then the device got lots of functionality again, and it looks great. It looks amazing thanks to Luton Hit for his great launcher and the fantastic applications that go along with my mod, you know. So you're gonna have a great device. Thank you for watching. This is the 15 euro tablet, and this is what I did with it, and this is what it became. So yeah, I hope you liked this video. If you did, leave this video, you know, a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, but only if you're gonna hit the notifying bell, so you're gonna be updated whenever I upload a new video again. All right, now bye bye.